Good evening, everyone. I hope you are doing well. Starting a little bit later than usual again tonight. Really need to stop doing that. I was mostly just having a stressful day today and needed to have a little bit of time to chill first before going live. So I'm feeling better now. So anyway, today I'm going to start off with. I don't even know how to pronounce this game's title. Is it like Dininho Adventures? Something like that. Also, just gonna put up the obligatory disclaimer. None of the games on IndieWash have been fully playtested by myself before this stream, so I may encounter one or two issues or bugs or anything like that. And not every game that I'm playing today has been released, so here we go. Dininho. However you pronounce it. Ah. So I'm dine and how. Oh no, you lost your eggs. I will help you get your eggs. Pick up 10 eggs to get an extra life. Duck. Hello, gamer! I'm the Duck Toriel! Press jump to overcome this obstacle. The longer you hold the jump button, the higher you will jump. Classic quack. Yeah, it's the Mac quack. Hold attack / run while walking to run. Jumping while running will make you jump higher. Some obstacles will be easy and a simple jump will do. And others will need a run-up. Use your fast little purple legs. Deadly Tail! Press the attack / run and pop the balloons to continue. You can bounce on the enemies. Try it on this minion duck. Hold jump while bouncing on the enemies to jump higher. Good sound effects. Hold up to climb vines. Press jump to swim up. Hold down while swimming to have more control. Congratulations, you are ready! Go ahead and be a real gamer! Thank you for playing, hope you enjoyed. There are 5 other worlds waiting for you. Consider to add. Wait. Is that all you're gonna give me for a demo? Huh? Oh, hold on. I guess it's not the end of the demo. That made it seem like it was the end of the demo. Yeah, it's a 2D platformer. Feels okay to control. Come on, I can get that one. Oh, NH in Portuguese is like N in Spanish. So you say it like dinino? It means tiny dino. Eggs! All the eggs. Yeah, this is a pretty competent 2D platformer. Not really having any issues with the controls or anything like that so far. Feels pretty good. Whoops. Din as in dinner, so... Dininho. Oh no. I'm down. How big this demo actually is. Thank you. Oh. Seems came around for quite a while. Well, it is called Definitive Edition, so... I guess this is like a... A remake? Or just a re... I guess just a cleaned up version of what was already out. Yeah, I've got the game's volume turned all the way up. I can turn it up in the mixer like that. But I'm gonna have to remember to turn that down later, because. Big sharks. There's some very odd looking bees. What's going on here? What is it? Whoa! Okay. Well, I thought that was a platform. Big bees? I had a big bee fly into my room I had a big bee fly into my room from my window earlier today. I think it was a bit lost. Tried to guide it out the window and it just wouldn't go back to the window again. Whoops. Colossal bees. Big bee! I mean, it was a very big bee that came into my room earlier. I'm not doing very well here. It's where the difficulty starts to take a steep turn. Big bee! Big bee, bring me the honey. Oh. If you hold down, it curls up. Still going, huh? Oh. Bub and or Bob's cousin is very cute. Hello, Tawai. That looks like a foreground. That doesn't look like a foreground element. That looked like a background element. Kind of threw me off. Oh wow. Okay, quite a lot to look out for there. How to jump off that? I'd like a checkpoint, please. There's the checkpoint. Remember, you can hit balls with your tail. Deep. Oh, hello, duck. Goodbye, duck. No time to explain. Jump into the bubble. Jump into the bubble. Well, that went well. Here. It truly is Bib. My friend Bib. Oh no, boss. Spring? How do you do this? Oh? Can I not? How do you activate the spring without being... How? How does this work? What am I missing here? This is such an odd premise for a boss. I can't even... What do you do? What's even triggering the... How do you trigger it? You're more than welcome to backseat on any of these games. I don't understand what's triggering the switches. Jeez, oh! Maybe. Okay, I guess I have to go I guess I have to shoot it the other way. There we go. There we go. Eggies, be mine! Oh, and that's it for the demo. Okay. Well, that was Dininho, or Dinino Adventures. It's an interesting little 2D platformer. Hello, Ronnie.
Generosity. Could be able to unite regardless of party or politics.
Number Wang. This next game is called Fairy Afterlight. I'm just going to turn the audio down a little bit again. Why have you disconnected OBS? Okay, stream seems to be live again. Blame BT for any downtime, because this sure is a thing that happens. My internet just decided to completely die. Which means the VOD for this is going to be split up in two. Yay! Thanks, Twitch. Thanks, BT. You are all really lovely. Does this game even have controller support? Hold on. Anyway, I assume I am live again. Okay. So, this game is called Fairy Afterlight. It is another 2D platformer. Wispy. We have reached a new place, Kimo. I did not expect that you will be able to use spider legs after fighting the giant spider below. Most incredible. We can explore many new places together now and find Lucentia. Let's go. It looks like a little bunny. I think it's a bunny-like creature. Say upside down shorts. This rabbit thing can do some pretty big jumps. I'm liking the style of this one so far. Using those legs? What legs? That creature, look. They kind look quite threatening, but don't worry, I can control them and turn it into our advantage. Controlling them needs energy, so spend it wisely. Bounce on it. But now what? Oh. Okay, you hold down the jump to do a higher jump. Welcome. I have all the things you're searching. Is what I'd like to say, but come back later, my dear. I just moved here, to be honest. Monsters have been raiding my place before. Sighs. I'll be waiting for your money. Okay. Now, come this way. Good thing that respawned. Thank you. Well, can't make that jump. Can I just... What if I try to propel myself across rather than just jumping? No, that gives me even less momentum. Okay. Yeah, this one is very pretty. Where exactly am I going? And I wouldn't be surprised at all if this is a Metroidvania as well. This very much seems like the kind of thing that would be a Metroidvania. Oh. And if this is a Metroidvania, I've already hit the thing that I don't like about Metroidvanias, and that is, where the heck do I go? Because there's just no... There's no clear indication on where you're supposed to go. And then I just end up going around in circles. Because it's even more difficult to explore 2D areas than 3D areas for some reason. Like, why am I going left now? That's like, why am I going backwards? How did I even get here? I've never been here before. Does this even have a map? This doesn't have a map. Some kind of boss sequence, I guess. I don't like the fact that I get propelled backwards whenever I do a hit. This would be a lot easier if I wasn't pushed off the platforms every time. Oh, cool. Just instant death that time as well. Thank you. Now what? Is that death? Will I die if I hit that? How was I supposed to know that? I think I'm done with this game. I get the idea. This is Fairy Afterlight. Not really my kind of thing. It's a bit too much of a Metroidvania for me to just stay engaged with it. This next one is called Chasing Static. Yeah, it's within the horror genre. It's not completely horror, but it lies within horror. I thought the trailer for this looked very interesting, which is why I had it on the list. Headlights. What box? Roadmap. Yeah, reading the roadmap while driving. Distracted drivers are the true horror. Last stop, 9:46. Well, I'm on a controller at the moment, and the game seems to be accepting controller input, so that's interesting. It's a very pretty style we have going on here. All day breakfast. £2.99 is pretty cheap for a fry-up.
Christ alive!
Voice acting! Hello!
Let me guess. Got lost in the storm?
You still open?
Sorry to barge in. You're still open, right?
Kitchen's
closed. It's me! I'm Chris!
You don't sound like you're from around here.
No. I mean, I used to be. Long time ago.
Where are you headed, anyway?
It's been a long day.
You know, conversation is normally a two-way thing.
Wait.
It's been a long day. Honestly, I thought that road would never end.
10 miles of trees. And, well, more trees. Yeah, it's a killer. We have coffee, though.
I'm, headed east. Oswestry.
Oh. So, do you want the good news or the bad news first?
Give me the good news!
Well, obviously I'm going to take the good news first.
Well, you're on the right road. We'll be headed that way myself soon. Bad news is it's about half an hour back that way. Hang about and I'll show you the way, if I can bum a lift.
Sure. To be honest, I could do with the company.
Wasn't looking forward to cycling in this rain anyway. Nothing creepy though. I'll kick your ass if you try anything.
Hey, I'm just relieved to be off that road. Where are we anyway?
Welcome to the Last Stop Cafe. Best coffee this side of the A5. Don't get a lot of customers these days though. Oh yeah, help yourself to coffee. I'll be done in 5.
Coffee, 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 cup.
So I never caught your name.
Coffee,
oh,
coffee, coffee, coffee.
Chris, right.
Nice cake. That's a portal cake.
It was my dad's name. My grandfather too. My parents weren't exactly ones to break tradition.
Well, it's nice to meet you, Chris. I'm Anera.
I used to know someone called Anera. It means winner, right?
Coffee, 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 coffee.
Oh, my Welsh is a little rusty.
Hey, I'm impressed. Most English folk can't even read the road signs.
Well, neither can I, apparently.
So what brings you to this neighborhood? Shit. I'm sorry.
Coffee, coffee, that's coffee,
fine.
Coffee.
We didn't exactly see eye to eye.
Coffee, coffee.
Yeah, my dad left when I was 6. Turned up 10 years later wanting to play Happy Family.
Coffee.
I still get calls from him. Not that I ever answer. I'll be finished up soon. Then we can hit the road.
Coffee.
You deal with that. Just mess with the dial until it finds a signal again.
Scary radio. Good enough. Just enjoying me coffee. It's busy. I want some cake. Oh. How the power's out, I guess.
Again, that's the second time this week.
Hold on, I've got is that radio not plugged into the mains? Store power to... Oh. Just tab to open your... That's a triangle on the controller, I guess. I have a lighter.
This is why I love smokers. You wouldn't mind taking a look, would you? Fuse boxes in the back.
Okay, I guess.
Last time I was waiting 4 hours for an electric...
Toilet!
So, what am I looking for here? Kitchen. Right. Hey, Nera, a bunch of these fuses are fried.
Should be some spares in there somewhere.
Dead. That's dead.
Got a fuse.
And the fuse is dead.
Many dead fuse. Oh, that's one working fuse. Where did she say the other fuse was? I was too busy being distracted by the fuse to not find the fuse. Coffee. Oh, that'll do. Oh, these controls are really sensitive. I mean, yeah, I wouldn't be surprised at all if this is, like, inspired by horror games from the PlayStation 1 generation. Resident Evil being like a prime example of that. There we go, got the fuse. Light.
Hey, no need to thank me or anything. Anera?
Toilet time. What do we have in the toilet? Anything interesting in the toilet? Or is it just a toilet? Plenty of loo roll. Yeah, I don't even have the option. Bad toilet. Oh no. What's happened? You know, that wouldn't have happened if I could have gone to the toilet. What's going on now? What is all this? Cassette tape player? Where do you get all this stuff from? Oh, I'm going to the woods. And now the line's dead. Look, I wasn't planning on going into the woods. Well, at least the cake is still in good condition. A Polaroid. Ooh, some kind of tape player. No idea what that is. Can I not do anything with the tape player? It would be nice if I could do something with the tape player. I'm not gonna exit the cafe just yet. I can't even make more coffee. I can't even get back to the coffee machine. There's a picture of coffee. Well, I guess I have no choice but to leave the cafe. Old reliable. Yeah, how dare they not give me any access to coffee? I need my dosage of coffee. Nothing back here. Dead power lines, I guess. Well, I have the option to stay or leave in the car. I mean, where else? There's not really anything else I can do here. There wasn't really anything in the cafe that I could investigate. I'm just gonna go with the only option. Can I read the map while I'm in the car again? Oh, the camera's moving real slow now. Come on. Get to the radio. Headlights. Radio. Can't do anything with the radio. Okay. So I'll just slowly go over to the glove box. Can I use the phone? Can I use the phone while driving? Mobile phone. Yep, that is exactly why you use the phone in the car. It automatically triggers a car crash. Oh, why is the camera moving so? Why not? I guess it's just some weird input issue. Lucky to be alive. I don't know, I probably wouldn't have survived that. But now I'm in the woods by default, even though I was told not to go in the woods. Why do I have to be in the woods? We're away from the woods. How about I swim my problems away? Nope, can't do that. Well, I guess I'm going this way. Surge into the sea. Some kind of bunker over here. It's a mystery bunker. Well, nope. Guess I'm not allowed in the bunker. There's a hexagonal fixture in the center of the door mechanism. Probably Moth. This is the entrance to Among Us the game. You go through that door and it starts a game of Among Us. Some mushrooms. Seem to be lighting the way over here. I guess I'll just go this way. Follow the glowing mushrooms. And you will go to the glowing shed. With crows. Oh god, that smell. I can smell it from here. This is a note. Oh, did that say audible chatter? Well, I picked up Valve. Always handy to have Valve on hand. Let's make my way over here. Suppose I can use that Valve on the hexagonal fixture. Is there not a run button? Can I not run? Aha! I found the run button. Stick the valve on the hexagonal fixture. And into the darkness I go. Thanks for playing the demo version of Chasing Static. The full game will feature professional voice acting, 2 hours of original music, and an engrossing story complemented by non-linear explanation across multiple open environments. To keep up to date with development, you can follow us at the links below. If you enjoy this demo, please consider wishlisting on Steam. Yeah, that was interesting. I'm not really a fan of horror games, but I'm sure there's probably quite a few people I know who might get a kick out of this. Especially if you like things like Resident Evil and whatever. Seems to fit that niche. Yeah, it was okay. Up next is B.Arc. Bark. Bio-interstellar arc. Bark, bark. TikTok Games presents.
All other exits have been compromised. I repeat, the bad teams through corridor
Miller,
B.
Get on.
Wait, I can't find Barker.
To the flight crew and animals, make your
Puppy.
Way to the elevator and prepare for launch.
Puppy.
Come on, little
Puppy.
Boy.
All clear from the launch team. To the crew of the Bio Interstellar Arc, good luck out there. T minus 10, 9.
Puppy.
Eight.
Strap in, everybody.
Puppies.
Six, five, four.
Puppies.
Three, two.
Why
one.
Puppy go to space?
Separating primary boosters. We made it, team. Set coordinates for sector four and drop. What was that?
One of the squids has a hole in the arc! It's pulling
us
back down!
No! Not the not the squid with the hole!
All systems are shutting down! I don't know what to do, Captain!
Miller, what are you doing?
Leave the puppies! Bye, puppies. Sleep, leave you all floating into space. I didn't even know that was the plot of this game. That's deep. Captain, we found... I can't read that fast. This is fast dialogue. Also, these dogs can talk now, I guess. Puppy pods. Is that like a rabbit dog? Moving about. Move to the targets. So basic training, I guess. Okay, so you just take your hand off charge. Puppy rescued. Was that a bear? Stage one. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's a bear. Just a bear with us for some reason. So you have to shut down the mining operations of the narwhal. Say this does actually control pretty well. It feels like a decent shmup so far. Unfortunately, I can't really focus on reading that dialogue while I'm already focused on what else is going on in the area. Checkpoint. Oh, I was underwater? Another boss. home is towards you. Final boss. Clone. At least I hit a checkpoint. This isn't so bad this time, because I actually have more health now. There we go. Yay. Bunny did it. Thank you for playing. That's a pretty solid shmup, if you ask me. I don't really play many shmups, but that was a shmup. It was pretty good. Doesn't seem to be too difficult either. And it does have its own difficulty options as well. Bio-Interstellar Arc. Buck. Yeah, that's pretty solid. Didn't really have anything to complain about there. This next one is called Born of Bread. This demo is intended to be played with a controller. Do we have any sound? Born of Bread. I don't think... Don't aim to showcase the potential of Beborn of Bread. There's still some mechanics that are missing, and the story presented here doesn't represent the main narrative of the final good game. There's gonna be a lot more characters to meet, worlds to explore, and gameplay mechanics to play with, but in the meantime, have fun. Oh, there we go, now I have sound. Born of Bread. We're here, let's go. Step out one by one. I had to press the button. Whoa, so this is the Forest of Roots. Pretty neat, loaf. Alright, people, as your guide, I have to ask you to always keep your eyes on me, and to stick to the group. Although it may look peaceful, this forest holds many mysteries and dangerous creatures, vicious and scary ones at that. What, like monsters? Yes, Flint, with teeth, claws and all. So you and Loaf stay close, alright? Anyway, today's expedition will take us to a very safe place, Vaulting Village. It's the oldest settlement in the Forest of Roots. In fact, has barely changed in the past 100 years. It's an excellent opportunity to study these fascinating dwellers in their natural habitats and learn more about the creatures of rural settlements, cultures of rural settlements. Brochus said there would be birds fighting? Ah, yes. One of Lorping's customs involves fights. But you'll find the history behind it very interesting. So, without any more delay, please follow me. I'm so excited! I've been hearing stories about the Forest of Roots ever since I was a kid. They say that deeper in the forest, there are small islands on the roots of the biggest trees. And at the base of the roots, there's the undergrowth, a super scary place, hidden from the sun and full of toxic water. Yeah, you're right. It'd be a good inspiration for one of my stories. But I'm good with hearsay. Sounds way too dangerous. What are you looking at? You're stressing me out. What? You saw thieves? Oh. So great is the calling of learning that I almost forgot the keys almost forgot the keys inside the bus. About that, Professor. Yeah, Beryl, you brainless dingbat. Would you believe I know all about the geopolitical aspects of the 12 Food War? But I can't even remember to keep the keys on me. Going after them? No. Splitting up from the group would be ill-advised. Have you had a good look at them? Good. Go to the village and hope somebody there knows something about these hooligans. Is that Braille on the front of the bus? Whee! Jumpy, jumpy. Wait. It's dangerous out there. Didn't you hear Professor Beryl? We need to go to the village. Walking back to Royal Town would take way too long. We need to find bus keys. Can I not control as raccoon? Let me control as raccoon. I guess I can't control as raccoon. All those trees are giving me vertigo. Even the Queen's castle doesn't go up that high. Don't say that to her, or she'll have you thrown off the highest tower. I have no idea when bread comes into play. Maybe we will find out. It says loaf in the bottom right. Lint, your buddy, raccoon writer of a green sweater. A to select. Can I not switch to raccoon? I wanna play as raccoon. Yeah. I mean, I guess I am kind of playing as raccoon. Following the moves. Huh, this isn't very rustic looking. What are those badges building here? What a jerk. Yeah, how can anyone be such a piece of baloney? What's going on? Our friend just locked us out of our property. He won't even acknowledge us. We don't know why he would do that. We were coming back from our shift in the village and found the gate locked. If only there's a way to get past that dumb fence. Like, this main protagonist character that I'm playing as doesn't even have any... communicates with emoji. Those feathers over there, you think they're a warning? Like, maybe they pluck traitors to death and display off their feathers to scare us off? With pastel-colored feathers? Get real, you bird brain. Wait, what did that say about raccoons? Oh, look at that tree coo. Elder? The tourists from Royal Town have arrived. The snag's mine. Ooh. Oh my. I'm terribly sorry. Welcome. I am the elder of this here Lapwing village. I do hope your visit here will be pleasant. And I'm the elder's assistant. Cool. Please follow me. I'll be showing you around. Pardon me, elder. Something happened and we need your help. What's this now? See those nasty badgers again? Cool. No, at least I don't think so. Some hooligans stole the keys to our tour bus. Loaf, go ahead and describe what you saw. Cool. You don't say, young peep. Yes, yes. You have been the victim of the Rock Goon Gang. Those rascals have been causing havoc all around the forest for a while now. Cool. If I remember right, there are three raccoons, each one more tricky than the last. They sound like a mean bunch. Who? You're one of them? Cool? Their leader? Cool? What? No! Elder, this is a misunderstanding, surely. Our friend Lint here is certainly not a miscreant. Cuckoo. Oh, my apologies. You do share a striking resemblance with their, leader, Cuckoo. If only we knew, the Rockoon gang is near impossible to find. Cuckoo. Although we haven't looked outside the village. If you want to look for them, come see me by the Chikitsu Arena. Cuckoo. I may be old, but I can teach you some useful tricks. Cuckoo. Well, I'll leave this up to you, boys. You can find me pretty much anywhere where there are interesting things to learn. Oh, and try not to get yourself in too much trouble, alright? Yeah, this game has some very nice graphics. Kind of reminiscent of Paper Mario. Cuckoo! Looking for the Elder? His house is the highest one, over there. We lost our ability to fly a long time ago by settling by this lake. Thankfully, Cuckoo, the mushrooms are here are super bouncy. If you want to get high up, we just need to find the right mushroom. Paper Mario in ray tracing world. This isn't even... This is just very good lighting. I don't think it's using ray tracing. At least I don't... It'll be like... I've forgotten what the other type of lighting is called, but I don't have RTX in my machine, so this won't be like real-time ray tracing or anything. Have you seen my brother? He's short, beige, has blue eyes. Kind of looks like me? It's so funny that bouncy mushroom platforms became a universal standard in 3D platformers. Maybe. Can you tell us anything else? Those are his most defining characteristics, unfortunately. Cool. He always hides in his treehouse when it's his turn to clean the nest. I'd go fetch him, but I have no clue how he gets up there. If you find him, then he's got some chores to do. Ah, that's a cute bug. Hello, cool. What are you? A raccoon. No, not you. Your friend with the annoyingly simple face. He looks not right. Oh, Loaf is a flower golem. He was created in an oven. Oh. Well, that makes sense. You're bread. Literally bread. Ugh, those two farmers make the worst puns imaginable. I can see that you don't have much more patience. You have to push more patience. You make me miserable. You were the bread all along. I am bread. Porto, hello. We got the finest mushroom farm in all Forest of Roots. The finest. Oh, are there more farms elsewhere in the forest? Nope. That's why ours is the finest. Cool. We got mushroom jelly, we got mushroom skewers, we got it all. I have no money. Thank you, don't hesitate to come back for more. After a hard day of sleeping and watching mushrooms grow, we all get together and watch the Chikitsu fights. The pleasant soundtrack we got here as well. I saw Chikitsu in a documentary once. At first, I thought I was watching a dumb comedy skit, so I changed the channel. Wait! Hey, Dub. Weren't you busy at the Saber's Guild today? The heroes I got assigned to got sick, so I came here to help you out. Here, you forgot your battle cards at the Saber's Guild yesterday. Ooh. Collectible cards. I know Loaf tends to forget his battle moves sometimes, so I brought the cards back to help you remember them. Oh! Also, I heard through the a grapevine that you might be training in the area so soon. Don't forget, we Savers have a responsibility to record and share all the progress made by our adventurers. So, I hope you don't mind if I stream your fights. Sure, sounds fun. Oh, cool! People usually don't like having me around, even though it's kind of my job. I promise I'll do my best to make you guys look cool. Are you ready to learn the ancient art of Jiu-Jitsu? Hiya! Cool! I like your enthusiasm, young peep. Pardon the saying, but you do look squishy. Do you have a weapon? Yes, a ladle. Cool! A fine weapon. Make sure to always equip your weapons before a battle. Open your menu to start. Cool! Select your ladle and place it in your backpack. Placed in the backpack. But be mindful of the weapons you bring in battle. You can't carry everything at once. On guard! Cool! I see you. Live chat? See, have you Saver's Guide official battle cards? Good. They'll help you pick actions against your opponents. Why don't you try making the first move, young peep? Select the attack card and use your ladle on me. Don't worry, I can take it. Cool. What kind of battle system is this? Card-based battle system. Interesting. Cuckoo! That wasn't half bad. Now it's your friend's turn. Humor me and use his brainstorm ability. Cool! Hold and release the left stick at the correct time. Sleepy sheep. Cool. Yes, see? This ability used up some of your will points. They are needed to perform most of your normal attacks. You have resolve points. Cool. These points can be used to perform normal attacks as well as special attacks. But I see you don't have any yet. Don't worry, you'll probably find some out there if you keep an eye out. Cool. Cool. It's my turn now. Try to block my attack by pressing A at the right moment. Sheep? Hello? I've never played the Thousand Year Door. I've seen bits of the Thousand Year Door, but I'm not really familiar enough with the game to know what you're going on about. See, when you block an attack, you won't take any damage from it, but remember to wait until the very last moment. Cool. Timing is key. I have a question. How are we supposed to win back will and resolve after spending it on our attacks? I do believe the Battle Broadcast can help that with that. But you'll have to speak to Dub about it. Cool. Technology is mumbo jumbo to me. Cool. But there is something I do know. Select your defend card and press A just before my attack, like last time. Gained one will point from that. Notice the difference between blocking and defending? Blocking on the enemy's turn only stops the damage, while defending on your turn will give you the will points on top of that. Once you fill your will points completely, you will start gaining resolve points instead. Defending is a big gamble.
Cool.
Make sure you are confident in your timing when defending against enemies, or else you'll take damage as a result and gain nothing. It'd be wise to learn the timing of your opponent before attempting to defend. Now you know the basics.
Cool.
You are disciplined, young peeps. Here, one of my fellow lapwings found this on the other day.
Cool.
It'll be more useful to you than me. Tool used by the lapwing droids. Long ago. Watch out, it's sharp. Thanks, Elder. Some weapons are stronger on certain enemies, while others less effective.
Cool.
Experiment and learn. Right, your raccoon problem.
Cool.
They're very elusive, you see. Help people around the forest and you might just find them.
Cool.
Look around and ask people. Maybe somebody has seen the Rockgoon Gang lately. It's a very interesting battle system. Sorry to bother you again, good guys. Just a quick word about the battle broadcast. If you battle well, the viewers will become happy and give you will points from time to time. But if you do bad, they'll be angry and won't give you anything. If you want to save your progress, come see me and I'll record it. So, you guys want to save? Okay, I think it's working. Got it! Time is ticking, and that nest isn't going to clean itself. Cuckoo! Well, I think I just made the nest more messy. I played with physics. This is your first time coming to the Lapwing Village. For us, it's our third time. Can't get enough of it. The clean air, the peacefulness, the nice folks. The mushroom jelly! Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Have you tried the mushroom jelly? It's so... Oh my gosh! I mean, the mushroom jelly is worth the trip on its own. You find some in the royal town, but it's so expensive and cheap tasting. I don't know, the mushrooms must spoil during shipping, because yup. This is such a pretty game. Like, just looking at this environment alone. Careful, guys. This machine is no joke. It'll flatten you in no time. My friend Loaf is super squishy. I'm sure he'd be okay. Your body is a temple. Respect it. You don't seem to be using it. Why do you leave it on? Crusher goes broom broom. You don't see... Oh no. That had to be a reference to the meme. Oh, I don't know what I'll do. Cool. What's wrong? My precious teacup handed over generations of lapwings is stuck in my old nest. Oh no, did you forget it there? Yes, cool. Those mean badgers forced us out of our nest to build a camping lodge here. I was so stressed that I forgot my teacup. We'll help you out, right, Lo?
Of course.
You're so kind. Thank you. Thank you again for finding some time for me, cool. Do I have a log of things that I could be doing in here? There we go, quests. Oh, I'm back over here again. Can I swim? So what happens if I go into the crusher? Yep. Oh, okay, that... Wait, you could... Can you use that as an ability? Yeah, this is like Wario Land. That's neat. I don't think... That's a neat mechanic. I don't think I've seen many other platformers outside of Wario Land that actually takes advantage of things that hurt you. Because Wario Land in its own is a very unique 2D platformer for the fact that you have to, like, deliberately hurt yourself to get different abilities to get around the levels. Hey, what you doing here? It ain't a place for kids. Wait a sec. Hey, you got plenty of time on your hands, right? Actually, we're on a super important mission. I'm sure, kid. Look, I got a job for you. Some saboteur is stealing the electricity we need from our solar panels. Find that thief and I'll give you two a brand new toy. Got that? Why don't you do it yourself, Mr. Big Man Badger, hmm? I am a Big Man Badger, thank you. Here, take this key. That thief also stole one of our padlocks. He probably locked himself somewhere. I'm far too busy to go all mystery gang on that thief, so get to it. Mario Squish was a thing in the Mario and Luigi games too. Again, I'm gonna have to play those at some point because I have zero experience with those games. Same for Bug Fables as well. I have that on the backlog. These are things that I have on the backlog that I need to get around to because I very much want to play the Mario RPG games. What are you building here? Camping lodge. City folks are willing to pay a whole lot of money to be out of the city. It's gonna be rooms by the lake, a living space with a sweet fireplace, and all you need to expect from camping. Isn't camping about experiencing the wilderness? People want to think they're in the wild, but don't actually want to be in it. That's where we come in. Why are you building it in the Lapwing's village? Actually, land ownership belongs to both the Badgers and Lapwings, so it should in fact be called the Lapwing and Badger Village. I've got complaints with the Lapwings, sure, but I'm just a worker here, you know? It's my job. Badgers have been away from the Forest of Roots for a long time, but we're back, baby. Why were you away? I never really listened during history class. Something about a war? All I know is that we came back here a couple of years ago and we've already got a mine set up and a few houses built. You work fast. Yep, your people actually helped build a lot of royal town during the past decades. Raccoon is just being me. That's what I do. I continuously bounce up and down on the spot. I like to bounce. I'm bouncy. That takes health. So I gotta go around. So there's something else over here. Oh, nope. What's that cool sword over there? That young peep, it's the Indigo Gladius.
Cool.
It's been here, stuck in those ruins for as long as any Lapwing can remember. Nobody can remove it from there? Whew, many have tried, and all have failed. You see, its Gladius is incomplete, therefore will not move. Its spirits are missing. Spirits? Like ghosts? Yes. Its power comes from three spirits that used to reside in the grip. Inside the grip. They scattered long ago, cool, and now they're lost. How do you know all this? The Gladius can still whisper. Ooh. It wants to be whole again. It took me so in... It told me so in my dreams. You're a crazy old bird. You got that right, young peep. We can find the missing spirits, cool. I'm positive the Indigo Gladius could finally be freed. I hope it comes out somewhere I can play it because I'm here for the shit. I didn't check which platforms this game is coming out on, actually. I'll probably say at the end of the demo. I'd be very surprised if this doesn't come out on the Switch, because this is very fitting for a Switch title. Yeah, look up Born of Bread. I haven't really looked up any particular information about this game outside of the Steam page. This very much does seem like the kind of game that would hit multiple platforms. This is a really, really good quality game. I'm surprised I haven't even, like, heard of it outside of the Steam page. I haven't seen anyone talking about it anywhere. I just found this through browsing the demos that are available on Steam. Some guys aren't actually fun to be around, they're also... Oh. If only that could be there a bit longer for me to read it. Find much about platforms. Maybe it's just PC for now. I didn't check whether the demo was also on Linux or not. Although I doubt it. One combined is a stray reply on Twitter saying they're aiming for a Switch release. Well, that makes sense. As I was saying, this very much seems like a kind of game that would appear on the Switch. Like, this is Nintendo quality. This is really impressive. Welcome to our mine, proudly operated by us badgers for generations now. What are you digging for? You're looking for all sorts of ores, but the most valuable thing in there is a very rare crystal only found in the Forest of Roots. Cool. Does it do anything special? It's a crystal, kid. It glows in the dark. And it's pretty. What were you expecting? Oh, I don't know. It could be a conduit to Earth's energy or hold some mystical power, you know? Some wild imagination you got there, kid. Now buzz off. Stop bugging me with your dumb MacGuffin crystals. Oh, dear. So Twitch is being Twitch, basically. The Rock Goon Gang? Yeah, I've seen them. They always loiter around our mine. Freaking kids. I even caught him inside one. I also caught him inside one time, but I kicked him out real fast. Nobody fools around in our mine. Well, until those monsters showed up, I guess. Also, hold on, I'm just gonna be right back 1 second so I can open my window. It's getting very hot in here. I closed it earlier because there were bees coming in. It's dark outside now. Time. This again? Hope it'll be better than last time. Monkey bored. Smell my finger. The chat is bored. Rude chat. Talking about F4RT. Yeah, it's like a it's like a live but fake in-game chat that spectates the battles. I've been having issues with my wood stove recently. Whenever I light it, it smokes the whole place. Something must be stuck in the pipe. Mind looking for me, pals? It's a bit weird to just ask two strangers to do that for you. Oh, come on, it's all dirty and dusty in there. And what if it's a wild animal that got stuck in and died in there? No thanks. So you want two kids to deal with it? You guys will have dealt with it in no time, I'm sure. I'll let you keep whatever's blocking the pipe. Can I get on top? And this is probably where I end up breaking the game somehow, because I'm trying to get on top of this house. Battle with physics here. Okay, let's go around. Money! I love the expressions of that raccoon character. Pepperoni! Hey Coddle, when did you get in the chat? Can I not use over those? Okay, I guess I have to defend them. Always been in the chat. I'm in every chat. Oh man, I'm not doing well with that. I need a bit of a better indicator for when to defend. Oh dear. Was it not the A button to defend? I love the idea of putting smell my finger unprompted in a random Twitch chat. I'm trying to remember how to defend. Is it not the... Which button was it? God, the raccoon's expression. Give the cupcake. No, I didn't want to give the cupcake. Oh. No, I don't want you pulling that face the whole time. Now I feel bad. I just fell. I did the same thing twice. Just want to get onto the roof of that building. No! No! Stay up there! Stay up there! There we go. The wood stove is finally unclogged. This thing fell out of it. Thanks, pals. Cool, I can increase Loaf's HP by 3. I'm really glad you didn't find a dead thing stuck in the pipe. So is that just an item? HP up. So they're just perks that you can equip. That's kind of like Gumball. Hey, I was enjoying the breeze. Want to save? Well done. You said there were monsters inside the mine? Yep, creepy things. I haven't seen anything like them in my entire life. Everything was A-okay. Just a couple of days ago, and bam, the mine's full of them. Pretty dangerous now. I figured I'd take some time off to figure things out. Can you equip that sickle? Hold on. Let's see. Aha! There we go. I'd assume that's equipped. I'm still figuring this game out. Rocks in this quarry are top quality. We use them to build our houses, but we also sell them to Royal Town. Just get on with this battle. Need health for the... Need health for Raccoon. Oh no, there's three of them. This isn't gonna go down well. I'm actually kind of curious what happens when you... when you fail. That's not good. I need to figure out this defending. How do you defend? What button do you... It was in the tutorial earlier, but I've already forgotten how to defend. There needs to be button prompts. I am so bad at remembering this stuff. This had saving, right? Okay. Right, is there... can I... This is going to be a nuisance if I can't remember how to use the defense function, because the defense function is how you get attack points back, I think. Hey, why did you lock your friends outside? My house is lame. This is way better. They won't accept a trade. I made the choice for them. Huh? Okay. Why do you think the house is lame? It doesn't have a door, and it's all dirty and unfinished and stuff. Sounds like you're just lazy. You're lame too. Wow, you really are a piece of baloney. What do you say? Huh? That you were a piece of baloney? That ain't true. I'm gonna show you all that I'm great and A-meat, okay? Here. They can have their stupid house back. Mine's gonna be way cooler. Who are you guys? I'm Lint, and this is Loaf. I guess I don't care. Go away, please. Whoa, you did it, guys. Thank you so much for talking some sense into our friend. Battle Ball Gust generates 2 WP when the meter is filled. It's going to be nice relaxing in our home. Loading screens are meant to hide new levels, are they? The loading screen tip that tells you why there's a loading screen. How goes your trip so far? This is nice. Well, I'm glad you're enjoying yourselves. My colleagues hate giving tours, but I find them refreshing. At any rate, I have some fascinating facts about the village if you're ever interested. Just check the video, it's A to block. Okay. So it's just... Do you just tap A when they attack? Because that's what I've been doing, and it didn't... It worked the first time around, but further ahead it didn't seem to be working. Tap A when it's about to hit. Feed the raccoon some cake. Also increase your HP as well. There we go. Now you're happy. Okay, let's get back to doing some exploring. Raccoon's mask absorbs light, reducing glare and... That's all you need to know. Raccoon's mask absorbs light. Light absorber. Defend. There we go. It's still very difficult to know. Like the button cue isn't indicated very well for that. Am I gonna have to unclog your... Okay, that's already been done. Yeah, this music is really good. I'll have to look into who composed it, because it might be someone familiar. I can't do the... There's not enough of a visual indicator for when you have to press the button to defend. At least they're dropping cake. Why can't I use the... Can I not... Oh, 3WP. So that doesn't restore HP. Ugh, what to do, what to do. What's up, mister? I'm looking for a ring to give my to give to my fiance. And there's the perfect one in mine. It was forged by Master Badger. And into this ring, he poured his passion, his romance, and his will to love all life. How romantic. Yeah, right. But I don't know where it is, the mine. And there's a bunch of monsters walking around. I can go look for it. Really? Whoa, you guys rock. Can't wait to give it to her. She's beautiful, wisest, and fairest of all badgers. Well, I guess it's time to... Hold on, there's stuff down here. You! Hey! Ah! You! You interested in buying some coo? Some stuff? I don't mean to be rude, but you're super shady, mister. Me? Coo? Shady? Ah ha ha! No! No, I ain't shady! Ha ha! See, normal people wouldn't have laughed us for saying that. Oh, come on, kid, you know how hard it is outside the village for Lapwing. Nah, you ain't got a clue. None. Okay, what do you want? I'm hungry, kid. Just, bring something to eat. Huh? Yeah, something salty, fat, tasty. Yeah. Yeah, something real tasty. Are you trying to sell us something? One thing at a time. Hey, yeah, tasty first, stuff later. Cool. No. No. Shortcut. The raccoon's mask absorbs, allowing them to see better in dark. Whoa, whoa, whoa. You kids are going in there? Hold on. Oh, Hold on. OBS is having a moment. Just gonna wait for that to stabilize. Am I live again? Am I here? Hello. Okay, I stopped the stream, then I started the stream again. Is that working now? It seems my internet momentarily dropped out again. Which is a shame, because it's destroying this... It's destroying my experience of this really good game. Anyway, I'm probably going to have to wrap this up soon because it's like quarter of an hour to midnight. This has been a really... This is quite a long demo as well. I think this has actually been really good. I really like this one. Not being biased towards the fact this has a raccoon, this is like a genuinely good RPG. Are you crazy? Something is sapping the power. So the mines are even spookier than before. Not only that, but the monsters here are super tough. You better head back, kid. Robert Kilpatrick, that... Hold on. I think I might know of this person. Okay, never mind, I'm not following them. Hold on, what else have they done music for? Scoopy. Male dog. Global Game Jam stuff. Hair Dash. Dice Tower. Seems they've done quite a lot of stuff. I'm gonna drop him a follow. Some good music. Not only that, but the monsters here are super tough. You better head back, kid. Wow, the nerve of some folk. We're actually looking for the Rock Goon Gang. Why would you want to look for those sneaky, good-for-nothing thieving raccoons? Sorry. Why are people so mean to raccoons? Yeah, well, they've been seen a lot around here, but good luck finding them with the power out and all. Board. Also, new battle music. Is this the same? Is this like a variation of the battle music? no. Oh no! Game over. I wasn't doing well in the health department there. I guess saves don't really work so well in this demo, considering it's put me all the way back there. But it seems to have saved the rest of the progress. So what exactly do I... Where do I get health? Or where's a useful resource for health? That's not where I get health. Yeah, not there. Water is not good for you in this situation. Gain back 12 HP. There we go. There we go. That should do. Unfortunately, I don't have the credit to buy more food. I'm gonna have to play a Thousand Year Door. I don't know when, but it will be something. Something that I'll get around to. Raccoons can run up to speed of up to 24 kilometers per hour. This way. Oh no. Get away! Get away! Ooh, pickaxe. Don't think I can get up there. No. Can't get up there. Well, guess I'm battling this thing. Yay! Money! Well, that way is blocked. Everything's purple, like me. I'll save. Use that. Well, that's it. Oh, I could have jumped up there. Got that pickaxe. I completely forgot that the pickaxe was there. Pepperoni! Pepperoni. The best encouragement in battle is pepperoni. Ooh. Max health, please. Actually, hold on. Max will. I think health is probably most helpful. See if I can get that pickaxe. There we go. An ordinary pickaxe. Nothing more, nothing less. Going on here. Oh. Oh no. More battle time. Can I just run? That's a very interesting flea mechanic. So you really gotta mash the button to flee from a battle. I'll just go ahead with it. Oh, now there's three of them. Nah, not a card game. The battles have card mechanics, but it's not a card game. Shit. I messed that up. No, the raccoon is a main character. Yeah, most likely. How much health does this guy have? I don't like the defense system though, because you really need to know when to hit the button to defend, and there's little to no visual indicator for it. There we go. Need to heal up. Hold on. What's our little star indicator for blocking? Well, it's not something that I've noticed. This is going to be a battle, isn't it? Three of them. This isn't going to go well. Now, I'm trying to hit the A button when those little stars appear, and even slightly after those little stars appear, and it doesn't appear to be doing anything. Pepperoni for luck. It's not working. There, it's like, that button timing is really stupidly precise. No chance. I think if I were to give any feedback for this game, the visual indicator for defending needs to be, like, that I need, like, some kind of better visual indicator for how to defend. I've got to go back and get the pickaxe. I mean, I guess technically I could farm XP from weaker enemies before going into this area, but I don't want to invest too much time in this because it's just a demo. And I'm going to be wrapping up soon anyway, because it is now past midnight. I just want to see if there is like some kind of ending point to this demo. Huh, only two of them this time. They're resisting that as well. This isn't going well. I'm gonna lose this one again. pepperoni for good luck, Cuddle. Good luck, pepperoni. Now I need to get out of here safely. I've spoken to you already. Oh my gosh, I was trying to rush through that chat. Keep an eye out for sparkle before your enemies attack. Okay, so that is the visual indicator, but when you press the A button, it's still very tight. You gotta get it right on time. I don't need this right now. No. Whatever. I have a pickaxe. Oh, whoops, that was the wrong... It did the wrong actions. Okay, I just accidentally started the game again. Okay, I think now is probably time for me to wrap up. I've been at this game, especially this in particular game, way too long. It's a very big demo. And I might as well just wait until the full game is out, because I'd be more than happy to actually play this on stream as well. Anyway, it's been fun. This has been a good stream today. I'm glad I actually put some time aside for it. This has been Indie Wash, and this game in particular has been Born of Bread. You can go wishlist it on Steam. I'm most definitely wishlisting this one. Anyway, good night, everyone. I will see you tomorrow for an Airport for Aliens, currently ran by dogs. I'm gonna be streaming that tomorrow. Very excited to stream that one.